Thank you for inviting me to this conference. The work we present here is part of the work done in collaboration between the research group of the Campinas University working in paraconsistency and the Spanish Research Council group working in Barcelona in fuzzy logic. The main results about the collaboration is contained in these three papers. The first one about exploration, about the relation between paraconsistency and degree preserving fuzzy logics. The second one, defining a new family of logical formal inconsistency arising from degree preserving fuzzy logics, and the third one, that it is the study of the intermediate logics between degree preserving, that it is paraconsistent, and truth preserving Lukasiewicz logic. The talk will consist in some introduction about paraconsistency and fuzzy logic, and the main topic is the study of intermediate logics and some conclusions. In the real world, the need of dealing with imperfect information, contradictory or imprecise or vague information, is quite usual. In the classical logic, if you have some set of premises that is inconsistent, in the sense that phi and not phi is possible to deduce phi and not phi, the logic is explosive, in the sense that all the conclusions can be possible. To avoid this trivialization, there are two main approaches, at least. The inconsistency handling is a non-monotonic mechanism that replaces the premises, the set of premises, by some suitable contradiction-free sub-theory gamma star. And there are several methods of obtaining this one. And the paraconsistent monotonic logics is the other way round, that is to replace, that consists to replace the deduction to a weaker deduction that it is not explosive. And in this sense, the definition of the logic is paraconsistent if it is not explosive with respect to a given. On the other hand, the fuzzy logic systems are logics especially tailored for reasoning with fuzzy, vague or gradual information. And the basic principles are: we abandon the bivalence principle, and they are many-value logics that are truth functional. The basic fuzzy logic systems are the ones introduced by Hayek in the book Metamathematical Fuzzy Logic, that are obtained in the following way. Given a continuous t-norm and its residuum, we define the structure over the unit interval, what is called the standard chain, obtained by using over 0,1 the operations min, max, the t-norm, the residuum, and the negation, and the constant 0,1, where the negation is defined in this way. The language of this logic is built from a set of denumerable propositional variables by means of the connectives weak conjunction and disjunction, strong conjunction, implication, negation, and the truth constants, truth and fails, that correspond to the operations of the standard algebra that we have defined. There are two notions of consequence over this logic, are the truth, the ones that defined by Hayek, and is the ones that is more used in fuzzy logic, is the truth-preserving fuzzy logic. This truth-preserving fuzzy logic is defined from a finite set of premises. You obtain some conclusion if, for all valuations over the standard algebra, if the valuation of the premises is 1, the evaluation of the and this type of logic is said truth preserving because preserve the truth value, the truth of the premises is imply the truth of the consequence. But there is another defined posteriorly, is the degree preserving companion of the logic of a tenor is defined in this way. From a finite set of premises, gamma, we obtain, we deduce a formula phi, if for all valuations on the standard algebra, the minimum of the values of the premises is less or equal than the value of the conclusion. The main features of these two logics are the following. The theorems of the truth preserving and degree preserving fuzzy logic are the same. When the premises is the empty set, the conclusions are the same. But the difference, very important difference, is the following. If from a finite set of premises we conclude some proposition in the truth preserving fuzzy logic, is the same if and only if the strong conjunction of the premises deduce this formula. Differently, in the degree preserving, the only thing that we can deduce when we can deduce from a finite set of premises a formula is the same that the weak conjunction of the premises deduce the conclusion. And this is equivalent to the, using some restricted type of deduction detachment theorem of the conclusion that the implication of the conjunction of the premises imply the conclusion. And but is this restricted type of deduction detachment theorem because you need to move all the premises as a when back to the other side. You cannot, for example, like in the deduction detachment theorem, to take only one premises and to move to the other side. This is not true in this logic. You need to move all the premises as when back. And what about the axiomatization? The truth, the preserving t-norm-based logic is axiomatized by a finite set of axioms and on and the modus ponens as the only rule of inference. The degree preserving fuzzy logic t-norm-based is axiomatized by the axioms are the theorems of the degree of the truth preserving logic, and we have two deduction rules. The adjunction from phi and epsilon, you obtain the weak intersection of them, and a restricted version of modus ponens. From phi and epsilon, if phi and epsilon is a theorem, then from phi you obtain epsilon. From the previous properties of truth preserving and degree preserving fuzzy logic, it is easy to prove that truth preserving fuzzy logic is explosive, because we can prove this implication, this deduction, and this from this we can deduce, so it is explosive. The degree preserving fuzzy logic can be paraconsistent. In what sense? In the sense that from phi and no phi, you can deduce only the weak intersection of the two premises. And there are two types of t-norm-based fuzzy logic. The contractive or pseudo-complemented fuzzy logics, where this implication is true, and so it is not paraconsistent, because from this we can deduce anything. But the non-contractive ones are paraconsistent. So we have the conclusion that the fuzzy logics, the degree preserving fuzzy logic, are paraconsistent even only if the truth preserving logic is not contractive or pseudo complement. From now on, we will deal in the second part, in the main results of the talk, with the Lukasiewicz logic that is pseudo complemented, and so the degree preserving Lukasiewicz logic is paraconsistent. Now we go to the main topic of the talk, that it is the intermediate logics between degree preserving and truth preserving Lukasiewicz logic. The main features of these logics are: the degree preserving is included in the truth preserving, have the same theorems but not the same deductions. One is paraconsistent and the other is explosive, and with respect to the semantics, one thing, when we speak about deductions in some logic, always we speak about deductions from a finite set of premises. And in this sense, the truth-preserving Lukasiewicz logic is complete with respect to the matrix defined over the standard algebra by the filters that contains only one. And the degree preserving Lukasiewicz logic is complete with respect to a set of semantics. The algebra is always the same, the standard algebra. But here the filters are the all the order filters on 0, 1. We can see that it is interesting to observe that we, in both cases, we can restrict the evaluation to only one algebra, the standard algebra. And in order to obtain the intermediate logics and to study what are paraconsistent and explosive, we will do two different approaches. One is the syntactical approach, define logics as extension of degree preserving Lukasiewicz logic with inference rules. The axioms of the logics are the same. And semantically define logics from arbitrary subsets of matrices, and we study of this type of logics. To begin the syntactical approach, it seems natural to extend the Lukasiewicz logic, the degree preserving Lukasiewicz logic, with the explosion rule. And we obtain that this logic, expanded by the explosion rule, is really an intermediate logic. Is, of course, is the minimal intermediate logic that is explosive, and the deduction of that is defined by the deduction is true if and only if either there exists a formula such that from the premises we obtain a psi and not a psi, and from the explosion rule we obtain any formula, or the deduction is already true for the truth-preserving logic. And this first condition can be equivalently written in the following way. For every evaluation, the evaluation of the conjunction of the premises is less or equal than 1/2. Following this line of research, we have analyzed the extension of the degree preserving Lukasiewicz logic by a weaker expression of the explosion rule of this type. And we obtain a family of logics, and even we have extended also with a family of explosion rules, a generalization of the explosion rule, that are stronger than the explosion rule. And with these two families, we obtain a logics, a sequence of logics from the degree preserving till the degree preserving plus explosion, that are paraconsistent, and a sequence of logics from the degree preserving plus explosion to the truth preserving logic that are explosive. In the semantical approach, remembering that the truth preserving and the degree preserving Lukasiewicz logic are complete with respect to matrices over the standard algebra, we began studying the logic defined by matrices over the standard algebra. In particular, we study this logic that is defined by the set of matrices where the algebra is the standard algebra and the filters are belong to the family FR, defined as the order filters that are contained in the closed interval R1 in the 0-1 interval. This logic, defined in the usual way as a logic defined by matrices, the deduction of this logic can be characterized by this condition. This deduction is true if and only if, for all evaluation, either the evaluation of the premises, the conjunction of the premises is less or equal than R, or the evaluation of the conclusion, or the evaluation of the premises is less or equal than the evaluation of the conclusion. And this type of expression can be translated to a inference rule in a quite easy way, because here phi super of phi is a formula such that for every evaluation the formula is when, if and only if, the value of this formula is less or equal than R. So this rule say from phi we can deduce a psi if and only if this value is less or equal than R, or phi is less or equal than a psi. Exactly this condition, and so this rule is exactly representing the logic defined by these matrices. In particular, for R equal to 1/2, we have this rule, because this formula is when, is evaluated in when, if and only if the evaluation of the formula phi is less or equal than 1/2. And this family of logics that we have defined previously satisfy the following properties. For R equal to 0, this is the degree preserving Lukasiewicz logic. It's monotone, all the logics are intermediate, and are paraconsistent for R less or equal less than 1/2, and explosive otherwise. One interesting question is, all intermediate logics are defined by matrices over the standard algebras, remembering that the degree preserving and the truth preserving are completely with respect to matrices over the standard algebra. But the intermediate logics do not satisfy this condition. And the example is the exponential, the explosion, the Lukasiewicz, the degree preserving Lukasiewicz logic plus explosion, because the compatible order filters with the explosion rule are those of the family F 1/2 studied before. But the logics do not coincide, are different. The idea is that if you want to see the difference, it is clear that this deduction and this deduction is equivalent to this expressions, and these expressions are different because the universal quantifier here affect all this sentence, while here there are two different universal quantifiers. So the exponential is contained in 1/2, and here there is an example proving that this formula, this deduction is true, is valid in 1/2 logic, and is not valid in the explosion logic. The same occurs for the generalization of the explosion rules. The two families, two sequences obtained before are also logics that cannot be captured by the matrices defined over the standard algebra. And by this, we arrive to the conclusion that the only result that we can give about the intermediate logics are the following. When logic is an intermediate logics in the Lukasiewicz setting, if it is a logic induced by the family of matrices AF, where A is an MB algebra and F is a lattice filter of A compatible with this logic. So, as a conclusion, we arrive to the conclusion that the intermediate logics in Lukasiewicz setting are a very big, very large lattice, and in particular, we have proved that with the last family of logics, we have proved that this the cardinality of the depth of this lattice is the continuum, and we are nearly sure that the width of this lattice is also the continuum. So it is very difficult to abort to try to complete to give a complete a full description of this lattice, and so we decided to study the particular case of finitely valued Lukasiewicz. The case of finitely valued Lukasiewicz logic, the last theorem became the following result. A logic is an intermediate logic of the n-valued Lukasiewicz logic, if and only if is the logic induced by the family of matrix AF, where A is a direct product of finitely many subalgebras of the n-valued chain, Lukasiewicz chain, and F is a lattice filter of A compatible with the logic. To study this, all these intermediate logics, we will deal in different cases. We began studying the logics defined by order filters over the n-valued Lukasiewicz chain. After, we studied the logics defined by lattice filters over the direct product of copies of Lukasiewicz chain. And finally, we need to study the logics defined by lattice filter over some products, but having not only the Lukasiewicz chain, the n-valued chain, but some subalgebras, and the product containing some subalgebras of this algebra. In that case, the problem is quite hard, and we have studied only the case, a particular case, the case of the logics defined by lattice filter over direct products of subalgebras of the n-valued chain when n minus 1 is prime, because in that case the only subalgebra of the n-valued Lukasiewicz chain is the two-valued Boolean algebra. As a particular case of the last theorem, for the case of n-valued Lukasiewicz logic, a logic is intermediate if it is a logic induced by a family of matrices AF, where A is a direct product of finitely many subalgebras of the n-valued Lukasiewicz chain, and F is a lattice filter compatible with L. Remember that this restriction of the algebras is exactly the restriction, because the algebras belonging to the variety generated by the n-valued chain are exactly this direct product of finitely many subalgebras of the n-valued chain. To study the intermediate logics in that case, we are attacking the problem by cases. First, we have a look of the logics defined by order filters over the standard chain. Second, we study the logics defined by lattice filters over the direct products of copies of the standard chains. And finally, we obtain a method to obtain the full description of lattice of intermediate logics only in the case that the n-valued Lukasiewicz logic, only in the case when n minus but when is prime? In the schema, first we have studied logics defined by order filters over the standard shell. And here we have the lattice of the logics obtained in the case of three-valued and four-valued logics. And as in the general case, the logic defined by the explosion rule does not appear neither in the three-valued case nor in the four-valued case. And so we need to go farther for studying the logic. So, moreover, the second group of intermediate logics contain, as a particular case, these ones. So thus, we will go to study next group of intermediate. In order to study intermediate logics defined by matrix over a direct product of the standard n-valued chain and lattice filter over it, we have obtained the following results. First, each lattice filter is a direct product of order filters over components, and you can remove the repeated ones, in the sense that if we have two components where the lattice filter is the same, if you remove this component, the logic obtained are exactly the same obtained using this component. So the number of the maximum number of components you need to deal to take into account are n minus 1, that it is the number of order filters over the one component. By a technical manipulation, here there is this technical manipulation, the matrix, when matrix of this family are of this type, is a direct product of the standard n-valued chain and a filter that it is the direct product of filters of type t sub pi 1. And this logic, the deduction in this logic is characterized by the following condition. For all evaluation over the real unit interval, A1, A2, A3, for all these different evaluations over this. If for all J, the evaluation of the premises is greater or equal to T sub J, then the evaluation of the conjunction, the evaluation of the conclusion must be also greater than T sub J. And this condition, the interesting thing is that this condition can be decomposed into X components, component a component, and equivalently rewritten as either for all evaluation, the evaluation of the premises is less than T0, being T0 the maximum of the values of the T1, TK, or for all evaluation, if the evaluation of the premises is greater than one of this TA, then the evaluation of the conclusion is also this. What is the advantage of this? The advantage of this is that we arrive at the conclusion that every intermediate logic of this type can be characterized by Boolean combination of two families of conditions that are the following. The condition KT saying that for all evaluation, the evaluation of the premises are less than T, or the conditions CT that say that for all evaluation, if the evaluation of the premises is greater or equal than T, the evaluation of the conclusion is also greater and equal to T. With this method, for example, the logic defined by the matrix explained in the previous slide can be characterized by the condition KT0 or the intersection of these conditions, where T0, remember, is the maximum value of TI. The advantage of this, such conditions are representable as regions of the direct product of the n-valued chain by itself and give a precise hint about the, for example, if you take this logic, is the matrix where the filter has these three names, the semantical condition is this. The part of this part of the condition is a condition that exactly means that we are in is satisfied by the Lukasiewicz, the four-valued Lukasiewicz, the degree-preserving four-valued Lukasiewicz logic. And the condition K1 can be represented by this rule, because K1 means that for every evaluation, the evaluation of the premises is less, strictly less than one, we can conclude anything. It's exactly what say this rule, because the fact that no phi and phi and phi is a theorem is exactly the condition that the evaluation of this phi is exactly strictly less than one. And so from this we can obtain any formula. Using this methodology we can obtain the intermediate logics defined by lattice filter of the direct product, and here there is the lattice, this lattice for the case of three-valued and four-valued logics. Is this lattice the full lattice of intermediate logics? And the answer is no. We need to study the logics defined by matrices over direct products where some component is a proper subalgebra of the n-valued Lukasiewicz chain. In our work, we have not solved the problem in general, but we have done a method to build the full lattice of intermediate logics when n minus 1 is prime. In that case, the only subalgebra of the n-valued Lukasiewicz chain is the two-valued Boolean algebra. And thus, intermediate logics are defined by matrices over the product of the Boolean algebra of two elements and a direct product of the n-valued Lukasiewicz chain. We have no time to enter in details, but here we are the result, the full lattice of intermediate logics in three-valued and four-valued Lukasiewicz logic. And in the case of three-valued logic, we obtain a new logic. In the case of four, we obtain seven that it is lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3, lambda 4, 5, 6, 7. Seven logics. Remember that the red one are explosive and only the blue one are paraconsistent. And an interesting remark is that for these new logics, we have not able to find a method to obtain its axiomatization. To end the presentation, we conclude saying that we have explored paraconsistent properties of the degree-preserving fuzzy logic. We have explored the logics between the intermediate logics between the degree-preserving and truth-presenting, and we have studied, not full studied, but we have studied the intermediate logics in the case of n-valued Lukasiewicz logic. Now we are currently work in the study of all logics defined by matrices with finite MD algebras and lattice filters, and we are studying the issue of maximality in these logics. Thank you very much for your attention.